I'm so happy to be here, actually, and I'm happy to see you again as well, because we haven't seen each other in a while, and you interviewed me a while ago, and it's really nice to be here, and the photo looks great, and actually they all look really lovely, so...
For people who haven't seen the photo yet, can you tell us a bit about it and your experience of shooting it?
You know, it was my agent was contacted by Brenda Ramsey, who runs YOUYOU Mentoring, and she basically asked if I was able or willing and free to have a photo shoot, and they have a wonderful mentoring scheme, and so I went to, I think it was Angel, and a beautiful big photography studio, and took about half a day, professional makeup, and then we did a little video. It's a really, really lovely day, and an amazingly talented young lady who took my picture, and I'm quite happy with it.
What makes a great photograph, do you think?
It's all in the eyes. It's always in the eyes. The eyes have to talk. I think the eyes have to smile. And as a woman, of course, seeing not so many wrinkles is nice, but you can't avoid it. So I think to make it as natural as possible. But I think the truth is always in the eyes in any way. And there's certain angles that are obviously nice to have, and I think she captured them beautifully. I personally love portraits, of people in everyday situations, and this obviously isn't one, but yeah, I think it looks lovely.
I have to talk to you about Thrones. The show just keeps on getting bigger and better. Why do you think it continues to have such a massive global appeal?
Because you never know what to expect. Because I think, I don't know if you watched last night's episode.
I haven't caught all of it yet, I've seen some.
I'm not going to give it away because I don't know when this airs, but it's just because you never know what happens in the next episode, who's around, who will die, who will be framed for something, who will be accused of something, who will go to bed with whom. So you never really know, and I think that's what keeps people on edge. And, you know, it's a very well-written show, it's great characters, great costumes, great set design, and... I think it'll grow. It'll be even bigger next year because it's just been renewed, hasn't it? So,
very good news to hear that. And I mean, obviously, you're right up to date with it. Are there any particular characters that you think have really done well this season? I mean, not just in terms of success, but really just been interesting to watch their journey.
I think Daenerys. I always do. I always think she is. I think whatever she does, every season, she just overrules to me. I think she's amazing. I just love watching her. And I think she's been amazing this season. And I mean, there's loads of really great characters. There's loads of new characters. And I personally miss Joffrey. I know everyone has their own opinion, but I thought he was great. So, yeah.
This season's not been without its controversies. I mean, particularly, I think the Jaime Lannister seduction scene has provoked a lot of discussion. How do you feel, I mean, particularly about that issue and about just kind of the general tone of the series?
Not so much in my household. We're pretty open. So, I think it probably has provoked a lot of discussion. But then you must remember, this is TV. This isn't real life. So to me it's entertaining. I mean, I get very involved in it as well because I'm a fan, as well as working on the show. I also love watching it. So, but I think I find it entertaining. Is that bad?
The Red Wedding episode in particular, I mean, a lot of the cast, they've even sort of filmed their reactions. What was your reaction the first time you saw that episode?
Well, I saw it a bit later. I will be honest. When I got cast, I read the books. So I knew it was coming. Did I know it was going to be this brutal and gory? No. But I probably reacted like, you know, some of those guys on YouTube when I went, and jumped out of their seats. I think I did a jump. I had some red wine before, so
I mean, looking back so far, obviously, I mean, that's been a very memorable moment for fans. But for you personally, do you have any favourite moments, favourite episodes looking back?
I think the Red Wedding was epic. I think it'll always be something. Whenever in years to come people will talk about the show, Game of Thrones, the Red Wedding will always come up. I think it's a very pivotal moment. I think there's more to come. But so far for me, that was the big one.
I mean, one of the things that really makes Thrones stand out is the fact there are so many strong and very complex female characters, which, I mean, particularly for a fantasy genre, is quite a novelty. I mean, how do you feel when you look at people like Maisie and Gwendolyn and see the work they're doing?
I'm a huge fan of Gwendolyn's, and she's just got Star Wars as well, so more power to them. I always think it's... I'm not particularly one of those people that says, oh, there need to be more. I think there's great female roles out there. Game of Thrones is certainly one of the few fantasy series that has created these incredible characters, and especially Maisie and Gwendolyn, and even Emilia. And I think they're very, very intelligent, strong, great women anyway. So they have been rightly cast in the roles they're at, and do it justice.
What's coming up for you next? Where are we going to see you next?
We'll see. I don't think I can talk about it just now, so you'll have to interview me again, hopefully. But I think something good is in the works. So,
is that something good on the small screen or the big screen?
It's going to be the small screen.
So. Something that is already out there, or is this something completely brand new you're going to be involved
with? I don't know if I can say. it's out there already, so we'll see. Once it's all done and signed, then I promise I'll let you know first.
We look forward to that. My final question, do you have a message for fans watching this, I guess particularly Thrones fans all around the world?
So grateful to be a teeny tiny part of something so amazing, and I follow a lot of Game of Thrones fans on Twitter, and they follow me, so I'm always kind of on top of knowing what's going on. Just very grateful to be part of it. Small part.